Honeypots can be low or high interaction. A low interaction honeypot typically emulates some network services, such as the web server. For example, it can speak the HTTP protocol. On the other hand, it is not a full version of the service. For example, the emulated web server does not have all the web contents and server-side programs. A low interaction honeypot is typically sufficient to detect network scan and probe and warn imminent attacks. On the other hand, a sophisticated attacker may realize that these services are not full version and probably are not real. A high interaction honeypot essentially replicates what a real server or workstation has in terms of operating systems, services, and applications. In other words, they look really realistic, and they can be deployed alongside with the real servers and workstations. Since a high interaction honeypot mimics a real server and workstation, an attacker may be attacking it for a long time without knowing that it is a honeypot. Therefore, we can learn more about the attacks. On the other hand, it is also quite challenging to make a honeypot look like a real server and workstation. For example, we must emulate user activities and network traffic on the honeypot. And this requires a significant amount of programming effort as well as data storage.